I'm a Professor Sami Assaf. I'm a professor at the University of Southern California, and I'm a graduate of Notre Dame from 2001. I took the honors math courses, and I was also a philosophy second major. And I went to graduate school at Berkeley, and I loved it. And then I went and did a postdoc at MIT, and I loved it. And I'm now a professor at USC, and I love it. And I'm obviously really like math. And I want to tell you guys a little bit about the process of applying to graduate school, how the logistics of it, how to go about doing it, and how to go about picking a grad school that's going to work for you. Because they're not all the same. They all have very different characteristics, and it's important to find one that's a good fit for you. So the first thing to know is, you know, from the other side of things, when we get applications for graduate school, we get a lot of applications. We get more than we can read. Even if we were willing to read them all, we can't. So the first thing, the most important thing when applying to grad school is you need to make the cut, okay? There's a cut that most schools will use, and they're not going to read certain applications. What this means for you is take your GREs seriously, okay? You do not have to ace your GREs. It's not important to get a perfect score. It doesn't necessarily help you to get a perfect score. I'm sure it doesn't hurt. But what you need is you need to be above that minimum bar. It varies from school to school, so I'm not going to give you a number, but study and do well. Because that's the main thing that we use, and we have a low cutoff, and we just don't look at applications below there unless there's some compelling reason that we already have to look at those applicants. Okay, so that's one way. Don't get weeded out. The first step to getting into grad school is you want someone to read your application. So take your GRE seriously, do well on them, and hopefully that'll happen. Okay, so now you've made the cut, and we're going to read your application. I need to remember your application. I'm going to read 100 applications. Okay, and some of them I sort of skim because honestly, it's like, oh, so many applications. Your applications should stand out. So how do you get it to stand out? One thing not to do is say, I love math. I would love to find a better proof for the four-color theorem. I think it needs a better proof. First of all, it doesn't. Second of all, everyone says that, even though it doesn't, which is weird. What you need to do is figure out, just sit by yourself and think, why do I love math? What excites me about math? Why are math classes my favorite classes? You know, what was a really great moment in a math class and why does it stand out in my mind? And after you write your essay about how much you love math and how enthusiastic you are, you should ask yourself, okay, if somebody else read this essay, if one of my professors read this essay and my name wasn't on it, would they know it was me? If your essay is generic enough that any of you guys could have written it, that's not a good essay because it doesn't really speak about you. There are a lot of great students. There are a lot of enthusiastic students. What makes you an enthusiastic student, personally? So it needs to be something about your experience, and just think about the memories that stand out in your mind, and you will find the thing to write about. This shouldn't be a really stressful thing. If you just think about your experiences and what you loved, you will find that thing that makes your essay stand out. And so that's one thing we look at when we're reading applications. But so what I do is, you know, we have that minimum bar, we get rid of most of the applications that way, down to a readable number. And then I go through and I start reading letters of recommendations first. I don't read your essay first. What's more important to me than your essay is, what do your teachers say about you? What do your professors say? How do you get good letters of recommendation? So when you're asking someone for a letter of recommendation, always ask with a way out. If you have time, could you please do this? And that gives the professor a way to politely decline. If the person's not going to write you a great letter, that person will decline. Sometimes they decline because they don't have time. So don't take it personally if someone doesn't write you a letter. But give the person an out. If they don't think they can write you a really strong letter, it's better to ask someone else. And now, how do you get a strong letter? You can stand out in someone's class by going to their office hours all the time and asking them tons of questions, if you actually have those questions. A better thing is to do an RU, one of the research experiences for undergrads, or do research or a senior thesis with a faculty member. That way the person gets to know you and gets to know you working and gets to see you in the environment where you're struggling to understand something, right? Math is hard. If it weren't, we wouldn't do it, right? So at some point you hit something that's hard for you. If you haven't hit it yet, you will eventually. Trust me, it does get hard. And how you persevere through that is what tells us how you're gonna do in graduate school. Because in graduate school, it's pretty much all hard. Right? You have an open problem that no one has solved yet. Maybe a lot of people have thought about it too. So it's not just because it's sitting there and no one bothered to think yet. People have tried and they haven't succeeded. And if you're going to succeed, we need to see that drive and that passion. And if you do an RU or you work and do research project here with one of the professors at Notre Dame, or you do a senior thesis where you're just trying to understand some difficult deep mathematics, that tells us, it gives the professor a sense of how you're going to be. and that professor can write a letter for you, and that letter will stand out. In the same way that your essay stands out, that letter will stand out. It'll be clear there's an individual, and this professor is talking about an individual, and that individual is distinct from everyone else, right? And it's not going to be interchangeable. And that's after, you know, we read these glowing letters, then we read the student's essay, and we're like, wow, this is someone that I think would be a good fit for our department. So that's really the key to making your application work for you. GREs, take them seriously. Write a letter that's unique to you and shows your enthusiasm and hopefully your competency. I mean, hopefully you guys are, you're all honors math majors. You're all good at math. But we really want to see your enthusiasm, and then we want to see how you persevere through difficult problems. And that's where your professors come in. They're the ones who are going to watch you. And it's okay if you get stuck. It's okay if you're doing a problem and you don't solve it. Because it's how you approach it, how you handle it, how you redirect and try to solve it. You're not going to solve every problem you try. Trust me, I can give you a few right now. Actually, if you solve them, it would be pretty cool. But there are a lot of really hard problems, and that's okay. The thing is, how do you approach it? How do you tackle it? And that's what's going to tell us, are you going to be successful doing research on your own? So that's sort of the idea. And then, of course, the other component to getting into grad school, now that you've got your application all ready to go, is where do you send it? So it's important to apply to a spectrum of schools. It's important to talk to the advisors here at Notre Dame who know you best to get their input. You can choose to ignore it. Some of us did. But it's always good to get their guidance. And you know, they will help you know, okay, should I be applying to Harvard and MIT and Berkeley and Stanford? And maybe that's enough. That would be weird. Or should I apply to a spectrum of schools? And then also, which schools? They're very different. So apply to a spectrum. And then once you get your acceptances, now think seriously and go visit those schools. And when you visit those schools, talk to everybody. Yeah, professors, definitely talk to them. Talk to the students, but talk to the second year graduate students. First year graduate students are bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Third year graduate students made it, and they're going to do great. Second year graduate students, you're going to find some of each. You're going to find some students who are doing great and loving it. You're going to find some students who are struggling. And you need to say, where am I going to fit in? Which one of these students am I going to be? Right? Am I going to be the ones that succeed? Why are these guys not happy? Why are these guys so glowingly happy? The second years, that's where your good information is. So talk with them. If you can stay with them, most graduate programs sort of facilitate you staying with one of the students when you visit. That would be a great thing to do. Get to know them, their life. What's it like being a graduate student at that school? It's different. It's so different from school to school.